الحمد لله الذي جعل البناء لذات الإنسان أساس الصلاح في هذه الأكوان.
Praises for Allah. Praises for Allah who made developing the essence of the human being the foundation of the rectification of the universe.
وصلى الله وسلم على المصطفى المجتبى من جاء بالصلاح من رب الإنسان للإنسان.
And may Allah send prayers and peace upon Al-Mustafa, the chosen and selected, the one who brought that which was the correction of and the piety of the human being from the Lord of the human beings.
سيدنا محمد وآله المطهرين عن الأدران.
Our Master Muhammad, and may these blessings also be upon his folk who are purified from all filth.
وصحبه نجوم الهدى الغرر الأعيان.
And also his companions who were stars of guidance and radiant elect
ومن
people.
تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم وضع الميزان.
And may these prayers and peace also be upon those who follow them in excellence until the day in which this balance, the scale of deeds will be erected.
أما بعد فيا أيتها النساء المؤمنات اعلمنا أن الله تعالى أناط بكن مهمات عظيمات.
To proceed, know, believing women, that Allah connected you to or made great missions and responsibilities based on your fulfillment of them.
خصوصا فيما يتعلق ببناء الذات لهذا الإنسان.
Particularly that which pertains to building or developing the essence of the human being.
اقتضت سنته أن تكون لكنا شؤون الحمل بهذا الإنسان ثم الوضع به وولادته.
He made or his wisdom dictated that you all, the ladies, would be the one who carried the human being and then eventually delivered him or gave birth to him or her.
فكما تبدأ التربية الجسدية له والتنمية بتكوين جسده في بطون كنا فكذلك منوط بكنا تربيته العقلية والروحية.
Just as the initial nourishment and development of the physical body of the human being began with ladies, the initial nourishment and development of the spirit and the mind of the human being does as well.
كما ينتقل من نطفة إلى علقة إلى مضغة إلى عظام ثم تكسى العظام لحما ثم ينشأ خلقا آخر في البطن.
Just as the human being goes from like a seed to something which clings to something which is like a lump of flesh, and then bones are formed and the bones are clothed with flesh, all of this occurring in the womb.
كذلك هو في مرحلة الطفولة ثم مرحلة التمييز إلى البلوغ يتنقل من حال إلى حال.
Similarly, from the stage of the human development called tamyiz, which could be translated as discernment, then the human goes on to the stage that's called bulugh, which is reaching a moral responsibility at the Islamic definition of puberty, and then through other phases as well, the human passes through these phases of spiritual and intellectual development.
فإذا أحسنت تربيته كذلك تحول وإلى إنشاء له في معناه إلى خلق آخر فتبارك الله أحسن الخالقين.
And so similarly, if the tarbiyah of the rearing of this human being is done well, then he transfers to another type of creature, and Allah describes this in the Quran, and then he becomes another creature, and blessed is Allah who is the great, the best of creators.
فتنفخ فيه روح المعرفة الخاصة والمحبة الخالصة.
So then the human being, the spirit of an elect gnosis, an elect knowledge of Allah, and a special love of Allah is then breathed into the human being. And this is talking about a spiritual development, just as that occurs in the physical stages as well.
ويكون عنصرا صالحا في مجتمع الإنسانية قائما بحق الخلافة الإلهية.
So then the human being will be a pious example among the human society and representing the divine, or literally bearing the divine caliphate or the successorship and representation of Allah.
وفي الإشارة إلى قوة التأثير المشترك بين الأم والأب في تنشئة هذه الأمانة بينهم قال صلى الله عليه وسلم كل مولود يولد على الفطرة فأبواه يهودان أو ينصران أو يمجسان.
And indicating this rearing and the effect that both the father and the mother have, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in his tradition, every child is born on its pure primordial nature, and then its two parents either make it a Jew or a Christian or a Magian.
ولكون ذلك التسبب مؤثرا في مسلكه طول الحياة عد الولد إن كان في الخير حسنة من حسنات أبويه وإن كان في الشر سيئة من سيئاتهما.
And because this path lasts during the span of the lifespan of the life of the human being, if the child is pious, he or she is one of the good deeds of the parent. And if the child is not, then he or she is one of the evil deeds of the parent.
وكان لهما مثل ما يعمله من كل خير.
And both the parents will have the likes of the reward of all of the good that the child does.
فإن قصر في القيام بهذه الأمانة كان لهما مثل إثم ما يعمل من الشرور.
So if they do not correctly bear this trust, then they have the likes of the sin of the evil deeds that the child performs.
فإن لم يكن ذلك بسبب تقصير منهما بل لعارض آخر عرض لم يكن عليهما من الإثم شيء.
And if this is not due to their negligence but rather due to some other cause, then they do not share in the bearing of the sin of his evil deeds.
ومع أن للأب دورا مهما ولكن احتكاك الأم بالابن والبنت أقوى وأكثر وأوفر.
And the father has an important role, however the amount of time that the mother spends and the effect that mother has on the child is more significant.
فوقته معها أكثر.
So the time that the child has with the mother is more.
واستماعه إليها كثير.
And the child listens to the mother very much.
ومشاهدته لأعمالها وأقوالها أكثر.
And his observation, the child's observation of the mother's deeds and word and speech is more.
فيكثر جلوسه في حضنها.
So the child sits in her lap a great deal.
والتصاقه بظهرها وصدرها.
And also the child will be often attached to her back or her chest.
ويرضع منها.
And the child actually nurses from the mother.
ويتناول تغذيته بعد الرضاعة وفي أثنائها كذلك من يديها.
And also the child receives his or her nourishment during the nursing and after from her hands directly.
وهي التي تتولى إلباسه.
And the mother is the one who dresses the child.
وهي التي يسمع منها التبصر والفكر في الأمور.
And he hears from the mother her insight and thoughts about things.
فيتكون عنده التصور والتفكير على حسب ما تلقي إليه.
And so his thinking and perceptions are based on what she tells the child.
فمهما أدت في هذا الدور الحسن فقد شاركت في الأساس الأقوى لصلاح الإنسان.
So if she does plays this role well, then she has participated in the strongest building, the strongest foundation of the rectification of the human being.
وبذلك حدثنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن حسنات كثيرات وثواب جزيل ودرجات رفيعات لما تقوم به من الرضاعة والتربية.
For this reason, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned great, many good deeds and great reward and degrees of elevation for what the woman performs of nursing and rearing the child.
وبداية التأثير من حين التفكير في تحصيل الحمل أو وجوده فعلا.
And the beginning of this rearing and protection of the child is with the intention prior even to the pregnancy and then also at the beginning.
فنيتها ثم نية الأب مؤثرات.
Her intention and that of the father have a great effect.
ثم ما يجري من نوع التغذية لها ظاهرا وباطنا مؤثرات.
And then also the type of nourishment that she consumes outwardly and inwardly has an effect.
ثم ما يصدر منها أيضا من الأقوال والأفعال مدة الحمل لها تأثيرات.
And then also what she says and does while I'm bearing the child, that has an effect.
فلكل ذكر لله تعالى وصلاة على رسوله وتلاوة للقرآن أنوار ينصبغ بها هذا الجنين.
So every dhikr that she does and blessings sent upon the Prophet and Quran which is recited has an effect through which that literally colors and affects the fetus.
كذلك لمجالس العلم والخير ولأنواع الطاعات الأخرى.
And also gatherings of knowledge and piety that she attends and the other types of acts of obedience.
ثم العمل بالسنن عند الوضع والولادة مؤثرات.
And then also her doing the sunnahs when giving birth and that has an effect.
من مثل الأذان في الأذن اليسرى وإقامة الصلاة في اليسرى.
For instance, like doing the adhan in the right ear and calling the iqama in the left.
ليكون أول ما يطرب سمعه في هذه الدنيا ذكر الله ورسوله.
So that the first thing that comes over the hearing of the child in this world is mention of Allah and His Messenger.
ثم في اختيار الاسم الحسن له تأثير.
And then there's an effect through choosing a good name for the child.
ثم في حرصها على بسم الله تبارك وتعالى عند رضاعه وعند تغذيته وعند إلباسه تأثير.
And then also her being cautious, being mindful of mentioning the name of Allah when nursing and feeding and dressing the child, there's an effect from that.
كذلك ما يصدر منها من الذكر وأنواع الطاعات سواء عند الرضاعة أو في خلال التربية.
Also the types of dhikr and acts of obedience that she does when nursing and also when not during the rearing of the child, there's an impact.
ثم رعاية عمله بالآداب عندما يبدأ أو تبدأ عنده الاستطاعة للطعام والشراب.
And then also being very careful about the courtesies the child performs when he or she is begins to be able to eat and drink.
فتلقينه اسم الله ثم اسم رسوله أول ما يتعلم النطق.
And then dictating the child the name of Allah and the name of His Messenger when the child begins to be able to speak.
كذلك في دعائها ودعاء الأب له.
And also in her prayer for the child and also the father's prayer for the child. There's a benefit.
ثم تكوين التصورات لديه والنظر إلى الأشياء بحقيقة ما جاء به الشرع المصون.
And then also correcting the perceptions of the child and the views that she had by showing him the views that she had of the protected sacred law. From the beginning of the child's distinguishing.
وفي جملة ما يكون في تلك التربية قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم مروا أولادكم بالصلاة لسبع واضربوهم على تركها لعشر وفرقوا بينهم في المضاجع.
And from what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم taught is his saying, tell your children to pray when they're seven and command and discipline them for neglecting it when they reach 10 and also separate on their beds at that point.
الانتباه من أصدقائه ومن يجالسه كذلك.
And also paying close attention to the friends of the child and those with whom the child spends time.
والذي يطرق سمعه وبصره كذلك.
And also what occurs to his hearing or his sight.
واختيار المعلم والمدرس له كذلك.
And also choosing the child's teacher and instructor.
وتحسين الحسن وتقبيح القبيح في نظره كذلك.
And making the child's, shaping the child's views of those things which are good and bad.
تعلق قلبه بالحق ورسوله وبالأنبياء والصالحين كذلك.
And attaching the child's heart to Allah and His Messenger and the pious also has an effect.
كلها مؤثرات في بناء ذات الإنسان.
All of these have an impact on building the being of the human, or the essence of the human being.
والارتباط شؤون الحياة ببعضها البعض فإن القيام بالواجب في هذه المرحلة مع رعاية حق الوالدين وحق الأزواج وحق الأرحام وحق الجيران كلها أيضا مؤثرات.
And also teaching the child to be cautious of the duties towards parents and relatives and neighbors, all of these have a favorable effect.
مؤثرات على الطفل الناشئ ابنا أو بنتا وعلى ذات الأب والأم وعلى المجتمع.
These affect both the child that's growing up, whether it be a boy or a girl, as well as the mother and father, and have a favorable impact on the whole society, in fact.
واحتشامها واحتجابها وتسترها كم له من مؤثرات في صلاح ذات الإنسان.
And the white woman's modesty and covering herself, all of these have a very significant impact on the piety of the human being.
هي في ذاتها وكذلك ذوات المجتمع من حواليها.
These affect her person as well as the persons of the individuals in the society which surrounds her.
ولهذه الحكم وغيرها أشرع الله تبارك وتعالى لها ذلك الحجاب والاستتار والاحتشام والحياء.
Due to this wisdom and other wisdoms, Allah legislated for her this modesty and shyness.
ولنأخذ نموذجا في ذلك في عالم الحس والظاهر وأمر العلم المادي.
So then let's take examples of that in the outward perceptible realm and in material things.
فقد أثبتت دراساتهم في هذه العصور وإحصائياتهم أن تحصيل العلوم المادية في المدارس تختلف فيه النسبة بين المدارس التي يكون فيها اختلاط البنين بالبنات والمدارس التي لا يكون فيها الاختلاط.
And he said in these times there are studies and surveys of children's acquisition of knowledge determine that there is a benefit of in terms of learning in schools that are not co-ed, in which the genders are segregated over schools in which schools that are co-ed.
فثبت تدني المستوى العلمي والتحصيل العلمي وكذلك السلوك والخلق في المدارس التي فيها الاختلاط.
So again, the studies prove that both the academic marks were adversely affected in a co-ed educational environment as well as the behavior of the students.
والله أعلم بمصالح عباده.
And Allah knows best that which is in the interest of His servants.
ومن ترك بابا من الشرع أحوجه الله إليه.
And if someone left a door, if someone knocked at a door of evil, Allah would afflict them with that.
فالتزام المرأة بالاحتجاب والاحتشام والتستر والحياء كم له من آثار في بناء الإنسان ذاتها هي والمجتمع من حواليها.
So how very great is the effect of a woman's shyness and modesty and covering herself on her individual, on her person individually, and then also on those who surround her.
ولقد أرشد صلى الله عليه وسلم أسماء بنت أبي بكر من قبل بلوغها لما بدأت تكبر إلى الاحتجاب والاحتشام ولما رآها في بعض الملابس قال إن الفتاة إذا بلغت هذا السن لا ينبغي أن يرى منها غير الوجه والكفين.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم directed Asma, the daughter of Abu Bakr, in her modesty, and he saw her at a certain time, and he said, if a woman reaches this age, if a woman reaches a specific age, what only her face and her hands should show.
فما أعظم إرشادات سيدنا المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So how very great are the instructions of Allah's our Master, Allah's Messenger, صلى الله عليه وسلم.
كذلك قيامها بحقوق الزوج وعملها بالإحسان مؤثر في المجتمع وفي الأطفال الذين ينشؤون في البيت.
And also her fulfillment of the duties of her husband, they have an effect on the society as well as on the rearing of the children in the home.
كذلك كلما كان يختل حسن الخلق بين الأب والأم فإن له آثار كبيرة سريعة على الناشئة من الأطفال عندهم.
And everything that is good character between the husband and the wife, or excuse me, between the father and the mother, good character between them, has a very favorable impact on the children who are being reared.
ولذا كان من شأن العقلاء إذا حصل بحكم البشرية والطبيعة النفسية شيء من التخالف بين الزوجين ألا يظهر منه شيئا على أبنائهم وبناتهم أبدا.
And for this reason, those of intellect, if they're due to, you know, just the normal, the human disposition, sometimes there will be disagreements between the father and mother, but those of intellect don't show any of that to the children.
فيكون ذلك أصلح وأصح لنفسياتهم ولطمأنينتهم واستقرار شؤونهم.
So that is better and more healthy for the children's tranquility and their souls and their stability.
وارتقائهم العلمي والفكري والسلوكي.
And also they're ascending in knowledge as well as their thinking and their behavior.
ولكن من لا يعي ولا يعقل يسرعون بإيصال الخلافات بينهما إلى أهاليهم وإلى أقاربهم فيكبرون المشكلة الصغيرة.
However, someone who doesn't have good comprehension and awareness, they'll rush to share their differences with their families and their relatives, and then they make this into a small thing, into a big problem.
وتحصل اضطرابات كثيرة.
And a lot of commotion will be caused by this, or it causes a great disturbance.
أخذ الله تعالى بأيدينا وألهمنا رشدنا.
May Allah take us by the hand and inspire us with that which is right guidance.
ألا إن لوعيكن وفقهكن وحسن عملكن الأثر الكبير في واقعنا وواقع الأمة من حوالينا فرعين هذا الدور العظيم.
Your comprehension and awareness and understanding has a great effect in your surroundings, so may Allah aid you in fulfilling this great responsibility. The first question says, we in Australia are currently contending with politicians who wish to abolish the wearing of niqab in public places, and it seems like they said and hijab, plus and also hijab. How would you advise us to proceed in terms of our individual and unique roles as imams, lawyers, and students, and how can we draw up the experiences of Europe in this to ensure legislation affirming its proposal does not pass. فسائلة يقول في أستراليا الآن بعض السياسيين يريدون أن يمنعوا لبس النقاب في الأماكن العامة وكذلك الحجاب. كيف تنصحوننا أن نتصرف بأنفسنا في أدوارنا كمحاميات أو طلاب إلى غير ذلك، وكيف نستفيد من تجارب أوروبا في مثل هذا في تعاملهم مع مثل هذه القوانين.
النصيحة الصدق مع الله تبارك وتعالى.
The advice is to be true with Allah, blessed and exalted is He.
وحسن الاستخدام للقوانين والأبواب التي يدخل منها فيما يمكن لإحقاق الحق وحفظ حرية الناس وكرامتهم.
And by trying to use the using the laws and the doors available to you to preserve rights and freedoms.
أن يتم مقابلة الأمر من جهة الدين واستخدام القانون كذلك بما لا يثير ويبعث على العناد.
And dealing with this from the religious point of view and also with using laws, however not in a manner which produces an obstinance from the other side.
أن يكون على استقامة وثبات من دون إثارات.
And that the people be upright and steadfast, however, not in a manner which is insightful.
إن شاء الله تعالى لا يحصل شيء من مثل ذلك الفرض، وواجب العاقل المؤمن عند حصول مثل هذه الأشياء أن يتجنب الحضور في الأماكن العامة في مثل ذلك الحال وهو على الحال إلا لحاجة أو ضرورة وعندها يتصرف التصرف المناسب.
And he said, inshallah, that won't happen. However, also the obligation of a believer when this is the circumstance is that they should avoid that type of dress in public places except when there's a need or a necessity, meaning when the circumstance is like this and this type of tension, avoid that in the public places except for a need and a necessity. And if one does need to go to those places, one does so with a behavior that is appropriate.
قال تعالى ويريد الذين يتبعون الشهوات أن تميلوا ميلا عظيما.
Allah said, those who follow desires want you to swerve or be very crooked.
أي فانتبهوا لأنفسكم واختاروا ما هو الأصلح لكم.
So then be cautious and mindful of yourselves and choose that which is most in your interest. This questioner said, how do I get rid of my drug addiction? I need help and wish to be on the right path as I was a religious person a while back. I'm not sure if they were saying I wasn't a religious person, I've become religious, or if I was a religious person and then I have this addiction. So I'm going to mention both to Habib Omar. Yasal, كيف
سائل ولا سائلة؟
سائلة. الله سائلة.
أيوة. شاك سائل.
سؤال مهم يعني في هذه الدول. The questioner asks, سائلة يسأل كيف أتخلص من إدماني المخدرات؟ وأنا بحاجة إلى المساعدة وأرجو أن أكون على السبيل السوي و. يكون كنت شخص متدين قبل ذلك أو ما أدري هل كان قسم لم أكن شخص متدين لكن المهم يريد التخلص من هذا المرض وأن يكون على الصراط المستقيم
بإحدى طريقين.
So Habib Omar said that one rids oneself of this addiction of Allah bless the questioner through one of two paths.
إما طريقة القوة في الإيمان والعزيمة والهمة.
Either through the path of a strong faith and resolve and an aspiration.
فبالإعراض والامتناع عن ذلك نهائيا ومفارقة الأماكن التي يسهل تعاطي فيها ومجالسة من يثير عليها.
Either by entirely leaving that and avoiding the places where one may encounter that easily and also the company that engages in that.
والطريقة الثانية طريقة من ضعف عن ذلك بالتدرج والتوصل إلى ذلك.
And the second path is the path of those who were weaker and they had to do this by gradually weaning themselves off it and taking a means to reach that point.
ولأجل الأضرار الصحية والاجتماعية الكثيرة المتنوعة من ذلك فقد صارت حتى الدول الكافرة تجعل لذلك معالجة للمبتلين بذاك الإدمان.
And because of the physical harm as well as the societal harm from drug abuse, even non-Muslim societies have programs to help those who are afflicted with this ailment.
ويمكن استخدام شيء من طرائقهم العلاجية للتخلص من تلك العادة القبيحة.
So one could use some of their remedies, the programs to recover from this bad ailment.
فالخلاصة في كلا الحالتين يجب عليه أن يسعى للتخلص التام من هذه الآثام.
So in summary, in either case, with either the path that one takes, one has to strive to be completely rid of this sinful practice.
فإما بالقوة الإيمانية والعزمة الصادقة النفسية وإما بسبيل التدرج.
Either by a strong faith and a true spiritual resolve or by a gradual process of recovery.
وعلى حسب ما يصدق يعينه الله.
And to the extent that the person is genuine, is true, Allah will assist him or her. There are many situations like work and university where interaction with the opposite gender are inevitable in Australia. If one is seeking a spouse, is it permissible or appropriate to speak to a colleague or classmate with the intention of getting to know them for a spouse without telling parents of either person or declaring his intention? To what extent can a person look for his own spouse? Is it more appropriate to request parents / a wali to find suitors and choose one of them? What if they don't have a wali? السائلة تقول في كثير من الحالات على سبيل المثال العمل أو الجامعة بالضرورة يكون هناك نوع من الـ من الـ من الاختلاط بين الذكور والإناث هنا في أستراليا. والشخص الذي يبحث عن زوج هل يجوز أو هل يصلح له أن يتكلم مع زميله في العمل أو في الدراسة بالنية أن يتعرف على هذا الشخص ليتزوج منه بدون إخبار الوالدين وكذلك بدون إعلان هذه النية، وإلى أي حد يمكن للشخص أن يبحث عن زوج بنفسه، وهل أو هل يكون الأولى أن يطلب من الوالدين أو الولي أن يبحث عن من يخطب له أو يعني لها، وماذا يعمل من ليس له ولي أو من ليس لها ولي؟
أما تطلب صاحب الدين والخلق فمهمة يشترك فيها الزوجة وأبوها وأمها بل ومن له بها صلة من الأقارب.
As for seeking a religious suitor, that is a responsibility to both the wife as well as her parents and everyone who has a bond with the woman of her relatives and so forth. That's a responsibility they should all assist her with.
والبحث على حصول ذلك المناسب الذي فيه الصفات التي أشار إليها صاحب النبوة، ولا شك أنه كلما تم من قبل الذي سبق له تجارب الحياة والإختلاط بالمجتمع أكثر يكون ذلك أوفى وأوفر من طلب الفرد الواحد.
And seeking the person with the right qualifications, the qualities that the Prophet ﷺ taught us, there's no doubt that the person who has more life experience and dealings in the society will be able to seek that person better than an individual would be able to.
فَإِنَّ الْمُسْتَشِيرَ يُضِيفُ عُقُولًا إِلَىٰ عَقْلِهِ.
And if someone asks for advice, then they add to their own intellect the benefit of numerous other intellects.
إلا أن ذلك البحث مما حصل فيه من الوهم المخاطبة المباشرة بين الشخصين.
And in seeking a spouse, one of the misconceptions that has occurred is that it's necessary for there to be a direct discussion between the two individuals.
وهذه طريقة تفكير خاطئ نشأت عند بعض البشر.
And this is a misunderstanding that some people have come to.
يدعى أن ذلك أنجح طريقة لمعرفة حقيقة الطبيعة وتناسبها.
And they make the claim that this is the best way to know a person's thinking and whether or not they're appropriate.
ويشهد الواقع في فشل كثير من مثل تلك الحالات.
And however, reality proves that many of cases like this actually fail.
وإنما الذي جاءت به الشريعة المطهرة وسنة المصطفى مجرد النظر.
And what the pure Sharia and the Sunnah of al-Mustafa brought in this regard is merely looking at the person.
أما مجرد الاحتكاك والمخالطة فضلا عن الخلوة فذلك لا فلا لا 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 يليق ولا يصلح أن يكون.
As for speaking and mixing and much less being alone, that's not good and it's not something that should be done.
إنما يعرف حال الإنسان في دينه وخلقه بوسائل كثيرة ومن خلال عامة عيشته وحياته.
And one only knows about a person's character and religiosity. There's numerous ways one can know, and also one knows through the summary of their life, so their general life experience, what they've done in their past life.
ومن خلال الجيران والمتعاملين معه يتبين الأمر أكثر.
And through a person's neighbors and those who deal with the person, this becomes more clear.
أما الاستعانة على تحصيل الزوج الصالح كذلك كالاستعانة على تحصيل الزوجة الصالحة فبابه مفتوح سواء من قبل الولي أو الرجل أو المرأة نفسيهما أو بعض أقاربهم أو من بينهم وبينهم مودة من جيرانهم رجالا أو نساء على حسب عقلهم ووعيهم كل ذلك بابه مفتوح.
And he said, and the door is open to seek aid in finding a husband, whether that or wife, whether that be through the parents or through the spouses themselves or through the neighbors or everyone who loves the person and knows them. So one can seek aid through numerous various people in finding a spouse, and the door of seeking this assistance is open for someone. What is one to do who has whisperings of shaitan in just about all of their acts of worship? ماذا يعمل من يوسوس الشيطان في أكثر أو أغلب عباداته؟
يستنصر بربه ورب الشيطان ورب كل شيء.
The person in this case seeks the aid of his Lord as well as the one who's the Lord of the Shaitan and the Lord of everything.
وَيَسْتَعِيذُ بِهِ وَيَلُوذُ.
And so the person seeks protection from him and turns to him in refuge.
وَيَكُونُ عَلَى وَسَدٍ فِي رَدِّي وَرَفْضِي مَا يُلْقِي إِلَيْهِ الشَّيْطَانُ وَعَدَمِ الْإِصْغَاءِ إِلَيْهِ.
And the person in a moderate way rejects and does not accept what the shaitan in a moderate way though what the shaitan whispers.
فلا يترك المجاهدة في ذلك ولا يبالغ فيها بحسرة كأنه هو القادر وحده حتى يستوعب طاقته بل يتوسط ويلتجئ إلى الله ويستعيذ بالله.
So the person doesn't entirely leave striving against the shaitan. However, they also don't act as though all of the power in that striving is them, but rather they strive and also depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek refuge in Allah.
ثم إن له في ذكر الله تعالى حصنا.
And then there is a fortress for the person through the dhikr of Allah ta'ala.
ومهما أراد أن يشوش عليه بهذه الوساوس ويقطعه فل يقوي ثقته بالله تبارك وتعالى ويفتح باب رجائه فيه.
And when the shaitan tries to distract him with these whisperings and cut him off, then the person strengthens his or her hope in Allah and confidence in Allah. The question I would like to know our thoughts in a person's mind all from Satan, and if not, how does one to know which are from Satan? فسائل يسأل هل الخواطر في قلب الإنسان أو في ذهن الإنسان يقول كلها من الشيطان وإلا كيف يميز الخواطر الشيطانية من غيرها؟
تكون الخواطر من الرحمن تعالى وبواسطة الملك وبواسطة الشيطان وبواسطة النفس.
The thoughts are from الرحمن, and also thoughts come at the means to the means of an angel and to the means of the شيطان, and also from the through the means of the nafs, which here will translate as the ego.
فالرحماني قاهر لا يقوى على دفعه.
So the Rahmanic thoughts, the thoughts of Al-Rahman are strong. strong and dominate and cannot be averted.
والذي بواسطة الملك تصحبه الطمأنينة ويقوى بذكر الله.
And those that come from the angel are accompanied with tranquility and become stronger through the dhikr of Allah.
ولا يكون إلا بأمر بخير ونهي عن شر.
And they will not be anything other than commanding good or prohibiting evil.
والذي من الشيطان يتنقل بين الشرور.
And those that come from the shaitan fluctuate from between various types of evil.
ويبعث بذكر الله تعالى.
So the devil thoughts will fluctuate and be weakened by the remembrance of Allah Ta'ala.
ويكون أمرا بالشر وتخويفا بالفقر.
And these will be a commanding of evil and threatening with poverty.
وتعالى الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء.
And Allah said that the shaitan threatens you with poverty and commands you to commit indecent acts.
والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا.
And Allah promises you forgiveness from Himself and beneficence.
وما كان من النفس فيكون مصحوبا بهوى لشيء مخصوص.
And that which is from the ego, it will coincide with an inclination or desire for a specific thing.
ولا يضعف إلا بذكر الموت.
And it is not weakened by anything but remembering death.
فما كان من وعد بالخير وحمل على الطاعات فهو من الملك أو من الرحمن.
So something that promises good and encourages acts of obedience, it will be from the angel or from Ar-Rahman, from the most merciful.
وما كان من إيعاد بالشر وتزيين للباطل فمن النفس أو الشيطان.
And that which was a threat of bad or trying to encourage wrong, that is from the shaitan. The questioner asks dua or advice to remove laziness in performing acts of worship. السائلة تسأل عن دعاء أو نصيحة لمعالجة الكسل في العبادات.
تجدد العزم بذكر ما ورد من الثواب.
By remembering what has been narrated of the reward.
وقراءة أخبار أهل الاجتهاد.
And studying the lives of those who strive, they made اجتهاد.
تقرأ آية هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة والرحمن الرحيم 100 مرة.
And reciting this verse and Surah
Hashr.
It's in some of the final verses of Surah Hashr.
هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة والرحمن الرحيم.
Yeah, up to الرحمن الرحيم. Of the final that verse of Surah Hashr up to الرحمن الرحيم 100 times.
وتكرر الدعاء النبوي اللهم إني أعوذك من الهم والحزن وأعوذك من العجز والكسل وأعوذك من الجبن والبخل وأعوذك من غلبة الدين وكهذا الرجال.
And repeating this prophetic invocation, seeking refuge from laziness. And both of those invocations are in the Khulasa, so you could review them there. The questioner says, when you are a mature and married adult, who do you have to listen to and please? Is it your parents or your husband? If that was the only option, i.e. if you please one, the other will be upset. عند التعارض للمتزوجة يكون عليها أن يرضي من الوالدين أو الزوج وقصدهم عند التعارض إذا تعارض إرضاء كلا الطرفين.
ما يتعلق بالأمر الخاص بالأبوين من إكرامهما فهما المقدمان في ذلك، لا حق للزوج أن يقطع زوجته عن إكرامهما والإحسان إليهما.
So that which relates to the specific matter or a specific command of showing honor and goodness, and honor can also comprise generosity and goodness to the parents, the husband does not have the right to prevent the wife from this.
ما يتعلق بخصوص الزوجة الخاصة كبقائها في بيته وعدم خروجها أو سفرها إلا بإذنه و شؤون معاشرتها معه فهو المقدم فيها.
He said, as for that which relates to the wife herself, of her not leaving without his permission and not traveling also without his permission and obeying him in personal things, her marital interaction with him, in that case, the husband takes precedence.
ومع الشرع حسن البصر والبصيرة فيما يراعى.
And with the sacred law, there is good sight, a good view and insight into that which should be given precedence.
ومهما كان طلب الأبوين لحاجة لهما أو لأمر يحبذه الشرع، فالراجح في غالب الأحوال تقديمهما.
And when the parents are seeking something they need or something that the sacred law encourages, typically they will be given precedence in this regard.
إلا أن يكون الأمر يجمع العقلاء أنه من قبل العناد أو الهوى أو التشدد في غير موضعه فذاك له حكمه.
However, when all the people of intellect agree that this is capricious on their part, meaning it's not a wise decision, it's a desire that they have, or it's out of stubbornness or severity, then in that case the situation would be ruled due to that.
كما يحصل أحيانا من التنافر بين بعض النفوس فيحصل تحامل إما من الزوج على الأبوين أو من أحد الأبوين على الزوج فيراد المقاطعة لغير سبب صحيح.
So for instance, if there is a dislike occurs between the two parties, whether it be the husband takes a disliking to the parents or the parents takes a disliking to the husband, so then they'll try to disrupt relations for other than a sound aim.
كما ذكر الفقهاء فيما لو طلب الوالدان من الولد أن يطلق زوجته.
So for an example of that is when the parents ask the son to divorce his wife.
قالوا إن كان ذلك بسبب صحيح لإخلالها بأمر الدين مثلا أو لتعمدها أذاهما والتنكيد عليهما حينئذ يلزمهم كثار الأمر.
And he says, so if that's for a correct reason, such as some religious discrepancy on her part or her mistreating them, then he must obey their command.
وإن لم يكن ذلك إلا لتنافر النفوس أو وجود التحامل لغير سبب صحيح شرعي فلا يلزمهم كثار الأمر.
So if that's only due to a dislike or them having some prejudice towards her for some reason that's not correct in the sacred law, then he doesn't have to obey them.
وفي الأمور موازين وعند الاستعانة بالله تعالى واتخاذ الحكمة تقرب الأمور.
And there are scales that way upon which these things are weighed, and when one learns knowledge of the sacred law and uses wisdom, that becomes more clear.
أما السائلة عن كيف الطريق لرؤية رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And the questioner asked about a way to have a vision of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
فقوة المحبة له وكثرة الصلاة والسلام عليه.
The Habib Umar said, then strong love of him and plentiful blessings and peace sent upon him.
مودة أهل بيته وصحابته الكرام.
And also loving the people of his house and his noble prophetic companions.
وخدمة دعوته الشريفة.
And also serving his noble invitation. Questioner asks, what advice do you have to a couple that are unable to conceive a child? سائل يشتكي من عدم الاستطاعة الحمل من الزوجين لا يقدرون على إنجاب أولاد فماذا تنصحون به؟
يكثرون سؤال الحق تعالى.
They should repeat it or may, they should ask the real exalted is he Allah.
ويكرراني آية ربي هب لي من لدنك ذرية طيبة إنك سميع الدعاء.
And they should repeat this dua, oh my Lord, give us from you pious, good offspring. Indeed, you are the one who hears prayers.
وَاقْرَأَنِي فَاتِحَةَ الْكِتَابِ 41 مَرَّةً بَيْنَ سُنَّةِ الصُّبْحِ وَفِرِيضَتِهَا كُلَّ يَوْمٍ.
And they should recite Fatiha 41 times between the Fajr Sunnah and the obligatory prayer daily.
فَإِذَا شَاءَ رَزَقَهُمُ الْأَوْلَى.
And when he wills, he will grant them children. What method approach and what should I say to my Muslim mother to make her want to wear hijab? كيف الأسلوب لبعث الرغبة في أمي المسلم أن تحتجب أن تلبس الحجاب؟ كيف أراضي والدتي المسلمة في لبس الحجاب؟
بالطلب من أرباب الحكمة والعقل أن يحسنوا مخاطبتها.
By seeking those of wisdom and intellect to speak to her well.
وأن يذكروا لها ما ورد في ذلك من الفضائل وما كانت حالات الصحابيات.
And mentioning the virtues that have been narrated in that regard. And what were the states of the women of the companions?
مع كثرة الدعاء لله تعالى وللحاح عليه.
And also with plentiful prayers to Allah Ta'ala and repeatedly asking Him.
فأن يرغب قلبها في ذاك الخير.
That Allah makes her heart desire that good. If a young child, 6 or 7 years old, sometimes gets very stubborn and doesn't want to listen what is said. It is to what is said. Is it okay to be very strict to him to teach him the right thing? ولد في سن السادسة أو السابعة يتعنت ولا يسمع الكلام. فهل هل يصلح أن يشدد عليه لتعليمه؟
يزجر بعض الزجر بمثل منع بعض مشتهياته حتى يقوم بواجب.
So the child should be censured somewhat or prevented from this by being denied some of what he likes. Until he'll perform his obligations.
والثناء على القائم بالواجب من الأولاد أمامه وإكرامه أمامه.
And those children who do fulfill their tasks should be praised in front of him and also treated generously and honored in front of the child.
ودعاء الله له أن يصلحه.
And Allah and prayers to Allah to correct this child.
وترغيب بإعطاء مقابل شيء يحبه. مقابل أن يقوم بواجبه في الدراسة وغيره.
And also encouraging the child through giving him that which he likes when he does good in his studies and other things. Can you please give a guidance on how one can create the best environment for stepchildren and how one should be with husband's ex-wife who is very resentful of one's husband or has tried to negatively affect your relationship? please can you give du'as of patience in against such protection against such harm. إسعادكم لإقامة أحسن بيئة لأولاد الزوج من زواج سابق والذي سعى إلى زوجة هذا الشخص كيف البيئة الأحسن للربيب وكذلك كيف تتعامل مع مطلقته وهي تتحامل على الزوج وحاولت أن تؤثر سلبيا على علاقتها بالزوج والدعاء للحفظ من هذا الضرر.
أما بين الأولاد فبالعطف واللطف.
And if it asks for with the stepchildren, that is through tenderness and kindness.
والتسوية بينهم في العطاء.
And equal, being equal in terms of the things that one gives the children.
وحملهم على إكرام بعضهم لبعض.
And also encouraging them to be generous to one another.
وأما للمريدة الضر أو وسوف بالإعراض عنها وإيكال أمر إلى الرب.
As for dealing with someone who's causing harm, the woman who's trying to cause harm, by ignoring her and entrusting her affair or turning that over to the Lord to deal with.
وزيادة حسن الخلق مع الزوج.
And increasing and showing good character towards the husband.
فكلما قامت بخدمته مع كريم المقابلة والمعاملة بطلت إرادات الإفساد.
And the more that the wife shows him noble character and treats him well, that will just ruin the attempts of those that are trying to cause harm.
تعتمد على الحق وتتوكل عليه.
And she should depend and rely upon the real Allah.
ومن يتوكل على الله فهو حسبه.
And if someone depends on Allah, Allah will suffice him.
كمل. هذا آخر شيء قالوا لك كمل. يعني المجموعة هذا آخر مجموعة. سرع.
How important is it to adhere to the lessons, teachings, etc. of one's murabbi, particularly being a girl in a family with other paths or inclinations. ما أهمية الالتزام بدروس وتعليمات مربي الشخص لا سيما إذا كان المربى بنت في عائلة ولهم طرق وأفكار أخرى وتوجهات أخرى.
يجب أن تتعامل مع أهلها وعائلتها بالحكمة.
So this girl must treat her family and relatives in a wise manner.
ولا تقصر في حقوقهم.
And she should not neglect their rights.
وإذا كان مربيها من الشيوخ الصالحين فهو يعينها على ذلك.
And if the murabbi is a sheikh of the pious, he will assist her in that.
وأما أهمية الشيخ الصالح فهو الحراسة من قطاع الطريق بأنواعهم.
As for the importance of a pious sheikh, he is the guard from all of the types of highwaymen.
النفس وشرها.
Of the ego and its harm.
الدنيا وكذبها.
The lower world, the world and its deception.
الشيطان وتلبيس الشياطين وتلبيساتهم.
And also the devils and their tricks.
والهوى وغلبته.
And also the false desires of the ego and when that dominates one.
لا يسلم من ذلك من أولئك القطاع المعترضين في الطريق إلا حسن الالتزام بتوجيه الشيخ.
One will not be safe from the highwayman that would try to disrupt one's path without the sheikh's guidance. I often come in contact with those who disparage Islam and our Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What is the best way to respond? Is it better to simply avoid them? يكثر احتكاكي بمن يسب الإسلام أو يذم الإسلام والرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. فكيف ما أحسن طريق في الرد أو هل ينبغي الإعراض بالكلية عنهم.
قال تعالى وأعرض عن الجاهلين.
Allah Ta'ala said and avoid or ignore those who are ignorant.
ثم لا يكون الاحتكاك إلا لحاجة أو ضرورة.
And then only come in contact with them due to a need or necessity.
ثم بعد ذلك أيضا تترقبوا فرص بيان صورة عظمة هذا المصطفى.
And then look for opportunities to show the greatness, make clear the greatness of this chosen prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
أولها من خلال التزامها وإحسانها وإتقانها لمهماتها وواجباتها.
The first of it is by her responsibility and good performance of her her responsibilities and tasks.
فثانيها من ذكر أو إهداء كتاب أو شريط فيه سيرة هذا الرسول وأخباره لمن يقبل ذلك أو يمكن أن يسمع.
And secondly, by giving the gift or mentioning some news about the, or giving a book or a recording or talking about the seerah of the Prophet ﷺ to those who will listen.
فصبرها وإعراضها وحسن التزامها وترقب الفرص لذلك مع دعاء الله هو السبيل الحميد.
So her patience and then her also avoid ignoring that nonsense and then looking for opportunities to clarify well, that is a praiseworthy response. If you are married, what is the best dua to make for a good husband and good children? الشخص إذا كانت المرأة متزوجة ما أحسن دعاء لصلاح الزوج والأولاد.
ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذريتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما.
And there's a dua that's from the Quran. Oh, our Lord, give us from our spouses and our children those that are a cause of the coolness of eyes, which is meaning immense joy, and make us imams for the people of taqwa. And that's a dua you'll find in the Quran. Can you please advise how one can overcome the effects of divorce on the heart and the level of iman? يطلب نصيحتكم لتجوز التأثير من الطلاق على القلب والإيمان.
تغين بأنه لا يكون شيء إلا بقضاء وقدر.
She should be certain that nothing occurs except through Allah's divine ordination and decree.
وتتصبر فيصبرها الله.
And she should endure to be patient so that Allah grants her patience.
ولتذكر مثيلاتها في هذه الأحوال قديما وحديثا.
And she should also remember the ladies who are like her in these circumstances of old and currently.
ولترتجي العوض من الله تعالى.
And she should hope that Allah will give her some recompense.
إما بإرجاء الزوج أو خير منه.
By giving her the husband to come back or better than him.
ولتشغل وقتها ونفسها بما ينفع ويفيد من عبادة ومجالسة للأخيار.
And she should use her time and herself with what is beneficial of keeping the company, beneficial gatherings and keeping the company of the pious.
أو مهنة تستعين بها على مصالح الحياة مباحة.
Or through some occupation through which she takes benefit, she uses to assist her permissible needs in this life. Is it haram to stay in this country permanently? هل الإقامة الدائمة في هذه الدولة تحرم؟
لا يحرم على الإنسان أن يقيم في أي بقعة من بقاع الأرض إلا بقعة منع فيها من القيام بفرائض الله تبارك وتعالى ويمكنه الخروج. فإذا كان في بقعة يمنع من إقامة فرائض الله ويمكنه الخروج فليخرج، وإلا فما في بقعة يحرم على المؤمن يشيها، بل قال النبي جعلت لي الأرض مسجدا.
It is not forbidden to remain in any place in the earth except in a place in which the person is prevented from performing his or her obligations to Allah, and the person is able to leave that place. So a place where one is prevented from performing the religious obligations and one is able to leave that place, it is obligatory to leave, is forbidden to stay. Otherwise, the Prophet ﷺ, it's not prohibited to stay in any place in the earth. Beyond that, the Prophet ﷺ said, the whole earth was made for me as a place of prostration, a mosque.
وقد بلغ السلام من السائل لنا من الشيخ تاج الدين الهلالي.
And there was a questioner, a lady who sent a question and conveyed the salam from the Sheikh Taj al-Din.
فعليه وعليكم أجمعين سلام الله ورحمته وبركاته.
So we sent salams to him and all of you and Allah's mercy and blessings.
وطول الله عمره في عافية وأعاده في عافية.
And may Allah give him a long lifespan and wellness and bring him back in a good state and in a state of well-being.
وأما التي تحب الاتصال بسند السير إلى الله تبارك وتعالى عن طريق أخذ عهد الطريق ممن لم يسبق لها أخذ عن أحد من المشايخ فقد حددوا لذلك وقتا اسألوا عنه بينكن فتحضرن فيه.
As for those who asked about connecting to the Senate in spiritual travel, for those who have not taken the path from another sheikh of the path, they've organized a time for that, and she could ask the ladies who are organizers, and they'll inform her of that.
إنما يكون ذلك لمن توفرت عنده الرغبة في السير إلى الله تبارك وتعالى وفي مجاهدة النفس ولم يسبق له أخذ عهد عن أحد من الشيوخ.
And that is for those who had a desire to travel the path to Allah and strive against the lower self and hadn't previously taken the path from the other sheikhs.
نسأل الله كمال التوفيق.
نسأل الله complete توفيق.
الجواب الأسئلة مثل المحاضرة مرتين.
And the question and answer was two times the length of the lecture.
أو ثلاثة.
Or three times.
والله يوفقنا ويكتب القبول.
And may Allah give us all tawfiq and right acceptance.
ويملأ القلوب بالإيمان.
And may Allah fill the hearts with faith.
ويبارك في اجتماعكم هذا.
And may Allah bless this gathering of yours.
ويكتب لنا ولكن كمال الاستقامة.
And may Allah write for all of us and all of you complete uprightness.
ويهيئكن لمرافقة الزهرة والكبرى.
And may Allah prepare all of you to be in the company of الزهرة, and that's one of the names of Sayyidina Fatima, and الكبرى, which is the nickname of Sayyidina خديجة.
الخيرات المحبوبات للرحمن ورسوله.
As well as those pious women who were beloved to Ar-Rahman and his messenger.
معانكن على القيام بالأمر كما يحب.
And may Allah aid you in fulfilling this command as He loves.
وجعلنا وإياكم في من يحب.
And may He make us and all of you among those whom He loves.
وضاعف البركة في دار ابن عباس ودار السيدة عائشة.
And may Allah multiply the barakah in Dar Ibn Abbas and the Dar of Sayyidina Aisha.
مؤسسات الخير في هذه البلاد.
As well as all of the good pious organizations in these lands.
واجعل فيها عظيم النفع للبلاد والعباد.
And may Allah make in them great benefit to both the lands and the servants.
في الخافي وفي الباد.
In both that which is secret and open.
في الدنيا وفي المعاد.
In this world and in the abode of returns.
في القلوب وفي الأجساد.
In the hearts and the bodies.
وبلغنا وأهليها المراد وفوق المراد.
And may Allah grant us and our families what we wish and beyond that.
أتحفنا وإياكم بنور اليقين.
And may Allah give us and you the light of certitude.
أجعلنا في الهداة المهتدين.
And may Allah make us of those who are guides and rightly guided.
ختم لنا بالحسنى وهو راضٍ عنا.
And may He give us a beautiful ending and He is with us well pleased.
سر الفاتحة إلى حضرة النبي محمد.
The secret of Fatiha and donated the reward donated to the presence of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم تب علينا إنك التواب الرحيم صلى الله عليه محمد وعلى آله وسلم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين الحمد لله رب العالمين.